Morning, students. This is Muralidhar, lecturer in chemistry. Welcome to our chemistry class. So far, we have completed Lewis Kossel concept and the second theory, that is Vesper theory, completed in last class. Today, I would like to explain valency bond theory. In molecular structure topic, valency bond theory is an important theory. This theory was discovered by scientists London and Hitler. Later, scientists Pauling and Slater were developing this theory. That means especially a historical famous scientist Pauling extended VBT concept to inorganic molecules, even to understand the properties of metal complexes. Particularly, Pauling, in his theory, he introduced hybridization concept. Simply we say hybridization operation. In order to understand the bonds present in the molecules, shape of the molecules, structure, bond angle of the molecules, and also stabilities, magnetic properties of the molecules. So according to Pauling idea, he had proposed interesting phenomena that is called hybridization. He introduced hybridization by considering valency cell electrons of an atom. That means baseline of his theory, valency cell orbitals or electrons of a particular atom in the molecule, center atom in the molecule. So before going to study in detail, first of all, we want to learn the definition of hybridization. What is this hybridization? Hybridization means the process of intermixing of unequal orbitals of an atom to give new and identical orbitals with respect to shape, energies, and symmetry of the molecules. That process we call as hybridization. So in hybridization, there are the involvement of different shape, energy, atomic orbitals overlapping with each other, overlapping themselves to give same number of hybrid orbitals. For example, two atomic orbitals are participated in hybridization, we are getting two hybrid orbitals. That means the number of getting of hybrid orbitals, which are equal to atomic orbitals involved in mixing. For example, two atomic orbitals involved in hybridization, you are getting two hybrid orbitals, then that hybridization we call as sp hybridization. If three are participated, then hybridization is sp2. one s orbital, 2 p r. Like that, there may be a involvement of 4 orbitals, atomic orbitals, s, p x, p y, p z. Then that leads to sp3 hybridization. We are getting 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. So, basing on hybridization, when we predict the hybridization in several molecules, we can able to understand the shape, geometry, bond angle, stabilities, some of the properties, important properties we can understand when we have the idea about hybridization, we can understand all those things. So here, what I am telling, the important acts in hybridization, I am explaining now, and students, I request you all, please you copy down step by step. See here, just now I explained hybridization. Hybridization means the process of intermixing of unequal orbitals of an atom to give equal and identical orbitals with respect to shape and energies, even having same symmetry, is called hybridization. For example, here there is the involvement of two atomic orbitals, you are getting two hybrid orbitals. That means mixing of s and p, we are getting two hybrid orbitals which are having nearby shape and same energies. For example, see this, there is involvement of three atomic orbitals, you are getting three hybrid orbitals, nothing but sp2 hybridization. So some important facts of hybridization we are discussing here. See, the number one, the first important point regarding hybridization, all valency cell partial filled, half filled, completely filled, as well as empty orbitals. Even maybe there is the presence of empty orbitals, some of that participate in hybridization. Participate in hybridization. Hey students, you copy down one by one. All these are very important, important base here, important facts of hybridization. And second one, just now I said, the number of hybrid orbitals formed is equal to the number of atomic orbitals undergone mixing. This is the second point. Then third point, hybrid orbitals form stronger covalent bonds than atomic orbitals. That means you are getting hybrid orbitals which are stronger than atomic orbitals. Stronger than atomic orbitals. The strength of bond depends upon extent of overlap. For example, there is a maximum extent of overlapping, we are getting strong chemical bonds, covalent bonds. There is a weak overlapping, we are getting weak covalent bonds. Then fourth one, hybridized orbitals may contain lone pair of electrons. May contain, sometimes in valence cell there is a lone pair of electrons. Those electrons don't want participating bonding, they remain as such. That's why hybridized orbitals may contain lone pair of electrons, but they never form pi bonds. That's why in calculation of hybridization of molecules, you can account, take into consideration sigma bonds, number of sigma bonds around the central atom and lone pairs present on the central atom. You can ignore the pi bonds. You can forget the pi bond, because pi bonds are formed in between unhybridized orbitals. That means pi bonds are not participated in hybridization. That's why pi orbitals we call as what? Pure orbitals. Whereas sigma orbitals we call as impure orbitals. Okay. Then next time, hybridization is a theoretical concept. Actually, this theory was proposed by Pauling in the year of 1927, on that time he made imagination, he gave a empirical imagination. That's why hybridization concept is a theoretical concept only.
So you write down that point, hybridization is a theoretical concept.
It helps in explaining
why this molecule has that type of shape. Okay, all those are important points. Students, you remember this. After discussing the hybridization, the main intention,
just you have to, being a chemist student, you have to predict the hybridizations, different types of hybridization in different molecules. How can you predict? How can you know which type of hybridization takes place in that particular molecule? So for that, I am explaining 3-4 methods, very important methods. Among them, one method is traditional method, normal method. Everywhere we have seen in our textbooks. The other methods are advanced, some technical based methods. Simply we call as magic method. Just by seeing the molecule, by observing the molecule, you can finalize the hybridization of that central atom. Which that atom undergo which type of hybridization, we can understand very easily. Okay. Now we are going to discuss different types of concepts for predicting the hybridization.
So, predicting hybridization in different molecules. So here I'll explain normal method, that is type 1 normal method.
Whenever you want to calculate the, you want to predict the hybridization in any molecule, whether it may be inorganic or organic molecule, whatever it may be, just you can count the number of sigma bonds plus number of lone pairs, that gives rise to number of hybrid orbitals. When we know the hybrid orbitals, if you are getting 2 hybrid, then hybridization is this. If 3 hybrid orbitals, you are getting number 3, that is sp2. You are getting number 4, that is sp3. For example, you are getting number 5, then the hybridization is sp3d1. Like that, we have 6 hybrid orbitals, then hybridization is sp3d2. So we know the number, we can examine the, we can answer the what is that hybridization, what type of hybridization in the molecule.
See, the first formula I give you here, number of sigma bonds plus number of lone pairs in the molecule, that gives rise to number of HO means hybrid orbitals. This is the formula, first formula, normal formula. By this you can understand the hybridization very easy. So let us see one by one. Students, have you completed this? Please note down first. Okay, for example, what is the hybridization in the following molecules, in the following molecules, in the following molecule. See, let us see hybridization in barium chloride. The first example I am taking here, barium chloride. Actually, barium belongs to second group. That means here barium contains two electrons, because it is second group, contains two valence electrons. So these two electrons are sharing with two chlorine atoms. There is a formation of two sigma bonds. What is our formula here? Number of sigma bonds. Number of sigma bonds means two. Is there any lone pair at barium? No. Then how many hybrid orbitals are meeting? Two. Then hybridization is yes. This is the way to calculate hybridization. It is a simple technique. Then second one, what is the hybridization in boron dichloride? So boron contains three valence electrons around it. Here three electrons are mutual sharing with three electrons of hydrogen atoms. There is a formation of three sigma bonds. No lone pairs. Total hybrid orbitals are three. Then hybridization is sp2. Then hybridization is sp2. So if sp hybridization takes place, the shape of molecule is linear. Bond angle is 180 degrees. Here shape is linear. Linear shape. Then bond angle is 180 degrees. Here shape is triangular. Triangular, bond angle is 120 degrees. Let us discuss another example, that is the CH bond. It is called what? Methane. CH bond. In methane, center atom is carbon. Carbon having four valence electrons. These four valence electrons bonded with four hydrogen atoms. That means forms four sigma bonds, no lone pairs. So total hybrid orbitals are four. Then hybridization is sp3. Shape is tetrahedral. Bond angle is 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Bond angle is 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Okay, like that, whenever you want the hybridization, just you can count sigma bonds and lone pairs. That gives rise to number of hybrid orbitals. Based on getting the number, we can understand what type of hybridization taken place in different molecules. Okay, this is the way, this is the one way to calculate. Okay, and I give you another formula. It is a fast formula to identify hybridization, type 2 hybridization formula. What is that? Group number of center atom plus number of monovalent total number of monovalent atoms by 2, that is equal to number of hybrid atoms. This is the second type of formula I give you. See how we use this formula to calculate hybridization. For example, here I am taking another example, ammonia. Fourth example. Up to this, we discussed third example. This is fourth ammonia. Here, what is the second type of formula I give you here? Group number of center atom. Group number of center atom is nitrogen. Group number is fifth group. It belongs to fifth group. That means it contains five valence electrons. How many total number of monovalent? Actually, hydrogen is the monovalent atom. It exhibits most of the cases it exhibits plus one charge. So how many monovalent atoms? 3. 5 plus 3 by 2. That is equal to 8 by 2. That is equal to 4. you are getting hybrid orbitals 4, then hybridization is sp3. That's it. Very simple. Mathematically, we derive the hybridization. Then I am writing another one here, PCl5. Here we are taking phosphorus pentafluoride. So we are calculating hybridization by this formula. Group number of phosphorus center atom is 5, plus how many monovalent atoms? Here 4 is minus 1. That means monocharged, monovalent, monocharged atoms. How many there? 5. 5 plus 5 by 2. That is equal to 10 by 2. 10 by 2 is equal to 5. Means what hybridization here? Taken place sp3d. So whenever this molecule having sp3d hybridization, then shape is TBD. Trigonal bipedal, bond angle is 90 degrees, 120 degrees. Remember this. Okay. In the same way, we will discuss another example. Let you take SF6. What is the hybridization of sulfur in SF6 molecule? 6, group number 6, monovalent atom 6, 6 plus 6 by 2. That is equal to 12 by 2 is equal to 6, means sp3d2. Whenever it is having sp3d2 hybridization, shape is octahedral, bond angle is 90 degrees. So simple. So this formula, it is very easy to understand the hybridization. Okay, this is the type 2 formula you are discussing. Right. For example, every student here, he got a doubt. Sir, what about the hybridization in ammonium ion? Is it possible to calculate the hybridization of ammonium ion by this formula? Yes. Here nitrogen 5, monovalent atoms are 4, plus 1 means this ion loses one electron, that means minus 1 by 2. Then you are getting what? 8 by 2, that is equal to 4. Here hybridization is sp3. That means here plus means there is a loss of one electron. That means you can subtract one electron, minus 1. You put minus 1. Then you get the answer very easily. For example, sir, I want the hybridization in boron hydride, BH4 minus 1 ion. Boron hydride. Here, in what way you are calculating? Boron, number of monovalent atoms. 4 minus 1 means it can gain except the 1 electron. That's why you can add plus 1, 1 electron by 2. Here also 4, then hybridization is sp3. So, plus means there is a loss of 1 electron. That's why here keep minus 1. Minus 1 means there is a gaining of 1 electron. That's why you put plus 1 in above formula. Then you are getting final answer. Well, this is the way. Then I give you type thought. Please students, write down quickly. Next we are going to discuss type 3 method. For example, type 3, if molecule contains oxygen atom, as a part of the molecule, then what we do is very simple. For example, concentrate the hybridization of carbon dioxide, like that sulfur trioxide. So here, one thing you remember, in above formula, group number of center atom and monovalent ions, total number of mono. Here there is no monovalent. Oxygen is a divalent. If it is the case, you can ignore the oxygen. That means you don't count the oxygen atom. Just you can count the group number of sunrad. Group number of sunrad is 4 by 2. That is equal to means hybridization is. See, very simple. Here you can ignore oxygen. Your group number is 6 by 2. That is equal to 3. Then hybridization is sp2. Just you can forget. You can ignore oxygen. Group number of sulfur 6 by 2. That is equal to 3. Then hybridization is sp2. So it's a very simplest case when the molecule is having oxygen part. Why you can ignore oxygen? Simply you can count the group number of central atom by 2. That's it. Okay? Very easy. That is type 3 model. What is this? Then the last magic formula, type 4. Type 4. We are discussing type 4 method. With the type 4, we completed hybridization. Of course, after completing this, I will give you hybridization table. Complete table. It will be useful for entrance exams. See, type 4. What is type 4 means? It's a very interesting point. It's a binary approaching technique. In type 4, by using type 4 method, we can calculate complicated hybridization in complicated molecules, complicated ions also. Okay. For example, see, by this method, we can calculate even oxyacids, hybridization in oxyacids also. For example, see, H2SO4, what type of hybridization is taking place in sulfuric gas? Like that, phosphoric acid. Then you can apply this method. What is this? Group number of sulfur is 6. Monovalent atoms plus 2 by 2. You can ignore oxygen. You forget oxygen. Don't count oxygen. Here, don't count oxygen. Phosphorus group number is 5 plus 3. Monovalent, total number of monovalent atoms 3. Hydrogen atoms by 2. Here, 6 plus 2 by 2 means 8 by 2 means 4. Then hybridization is sp3. Here, 8 by 2 means 4. Hybridization is sp3. So, very easy. The calculation of hybridization, even complex molecules like oxyacid, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, any oxyacid by this method. Okay? But what about type 4? This is a magic formula. Magic formula. Why it is called magic formula, magic method means? In periodic table, there are magic numbers. What is that? From when we move down from top to bottom, that means period to period, each and every element, there is a difference of atomic number 2, 8, 8, 18, 18, 32. Those numbers are called periodic numbers or magic numbers. Okay. Here, this is called magic formula. Why means, see, we have to calculate the, we are going to calculate the hybridization in complex ion, that is Z ion, N3 minus 1. Z ion. Somewhat it is tough to identify the hybridization like azide polyhydride ions. So here, in what way we are identifying hybridization azide ion means, actually nitrogen contains 5 valence electrons. That means it belongs to 5th group, it contains 5 valence. 3, 5, 15. Minus 1 means it accepts 1 electron. Total number of electrons in azide ion is 16. This 16 is divided with the 8 magic number. It is divided with 8, that is magic number. So 8 twos are 16. How much value of product you are getting? 2. That means this you consider as hybrid orbitals. 2 hybrid orbitals means yes. So in azide ion, there is a sp hybridization. Okay? That's why it is called magic formula. The total is divided with one of the magic number of periodic table. Okay? You can easily understand by observing other examples. This is very important. And we are calculating the hybridization I3 minus 1. This is somewhat tough to understand the hybridization like the ions like I3 minus 1, N3 minus 1. See, Here iodine contains how many valence electrons? 7, 3, 7. 21 minus 1 means it acts at 1 electron. So total number of electrons present in this poly-ided ion 22. It is divided with magic number 8. 8 2s are 16. How much here? 6. This is divided with another magic number, that is 2. 2 3s are 6. That overall net profit, total profit, 2 plus 3, total profit, 2 plus 3. In our hybridization language, there are 5 hybrid electrons. Then hybridization is sp3d. That's it. sp3d.
Okay. For example, we see another example. For example, NO3 minus 1.
You can calculate the hybridization in nitrate ion by using magic formula. So, how many valence electrons? Nitrogen 5, oxygen 6, 3, 6, 18. Minus 1 means it can accept 1 electron. So, total valence electrons are 24. 18 plus 1, 9. Plus 18 plus 1, 19 plus 5, 24. So total valence electrons are 24. It is divided with magic number 8. Then what is that 8 threes are? 24. Then profit. That means we consider these are hybrid orbitals. Then hybrid orbitals 3 means hybridization
is sp2. Okay.
So this is the simplest technique, magic technique, to identify hybridization in every inorganic, every organic, whatever it may be. Okay. So these are the techniques which helps to understand the types of hybridization present in different types of molecules. Okay. The remaining part, let me stop here. The remaining part we'll discuss in next class. The students who can watch our video, please subscribe. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.